If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. Long this one here's taken overseas in the middle of hell, 1943. Almost see my breath. That was my tail gunner, old Johnny McGee. He was a high school teacher from New Orleans, and he had my back right through the day we left. If it looked like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, should have seen it in color. A picture's worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray can cover. Should have seen it in color. One, this is me and Grandma in the summer sun, all dressed up the day we set our vows. Can't tell it here, but it was hot that June, and that rose was red and her eyes are blue. And just look at that smile, I was so proud.
While we remain standing for a moment. The reason why I ask you to remain standing is because you as witnesses have a part to play in this. And that part that you have to play is that you need to be supportive of this union. And so I say to you guys today, you need to be supportive of them, not talk about them, not talk down about them. When they come to you with an issue or a problem, put them back together, send them back home, put them in a room. Do something for them. If anybody in here is willing to be supportive and joyous about this union, say I do.
Amen.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the sight of God and in the presence of His company to unite this man and this woman in holy matrimony. Marriage was ordained by God in the Garden of Eden and confirmed in Cana of Galilee by the presence of the Lord, and is declared by Apostle Paul to not only be honorable among all men, but he said it's a good thing. And not only a good thing, but it's a good thing to find a good woman. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
On this occasion, we began by asking God's blessing on this marriage service. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you now. And as we began the ceremony, we bless your name and we ask your blessings upon this couple as they venture off in the newness of life as one. We thank you, give you praise in the midst of these witnesses. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, marriage was ordained in the tradition of the Apostle Paul for procreation, remedy against sin, and the mutual society. And as both of the congregation and of the couple, for any reason that this man and this woman should not be joined together in holy matrimony, let them speak now or forever hold your peace. To these two young men, I asked you, who gives this woman to be married or wed to this man? If it is you two, say I do. Have a seat. All right. That's right. Give us some love. Give us some love. The Psalm of Solomon, the 8th chapter, place me like a seal over your heart, like a seal on your home. For love is as strong as death. It's jealous. It yields as the grave. It burns like a blazing fire, like the mighty flame. Many waters cannot quench love. Rivers cannot wash it away. If one were to give all the wealth of his house for love, it would be utterly spoiled. Love is a great thing, and is a great thing in the eyes of God. God says that you should love one another as he has loved us. And that's an awful, powerful love, because remember, he gave his life for the sake of love. Amen? Two are better than one, because they have a good return for their soul. For if they fall, one will lift up his other. But woe to him who is alone when he falls and has not another to lift him up. Again, if two be together, they are warm. But how can one be warm alone? And though a man might prevail against one who is alone, two will withstand him. We come to join this couple. And you answer me by saying, I do. It says, do you, Mike, take the law to be your wedded wife? Do you promise to love her, honor her, cherish her, and protect her, forsaking all others for her, and holding only on to her? You can answer by saying, I do. Miss Pilar, I want you to repeat after me. Say, I need you to repeat your name. I take thee. Okay, come on with it. To be my husband. To have and to hold. In sickness and in health, for better or for worse, for rich or for poor, for as long as we both shall live. Isn't that something? Amen. Amen. Repeat after me. With this ring, I be pledged in the name of the Father, name of the Son, and the name of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Say, with this ring, I declare my love for the rest of my life. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. Father God, we thank you now. We ask you to accept the vows that you've heard from Mike and from Pilar. Now, Lord, we ask you to seal their love, and not only that, but seal their vows to one another. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. But ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Mike Heron. Son, you may salute your bride. Mr. and Mrs. Mike Heron.
Can you start telling us something?
Yeah, you can come.
Outside, I've got the month of May. Into my family, and to Mrs. and Mr. Michael Ryan Heron, I say, may you have as good a
speak now,
good as marriage as me and my wife have had.
40 years.
We've been married 40 years.
I hope
you guys last that long or longer.
I'm so happy you're my stepdad. I love you both very much. And I'm glad you guys are together. I know everything's going to get good. I'm trying not to be that big of a problem for you guys.
Thanks, Emily.
Cheers.
I'd like to make a toast.
Chug.
I can't eat.
I want to say a few words.
Oh, man, that's the wrong
case. All right, that's your piece. You ready?
Don't mash on each other's mouth.
Okay, here, take out.
Do a little. Put it on his face.
Get him now.
I told you. Smashing. Take a bite and then smash him.
You won't do it.
Very good.
Yeah, welcome to Joe.